Welcome, welcome to Christ Center International House of God. We will have a wonderful meeting. You will be empowered in the name of Jesus by God's grace and His enablement. Hallelujah. Let us come to the Lord in the name of Jesus. Let us come together in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We're going to have translation later. At least 40 tashma. Now, good to praise the Lord. So let us go before the Lord in prayer right now. Amen. You can see the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Heavenly Father, we thank you in the mighty name of Jesus for all that you are about to do tonight. In the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord, in Jesus' mighty name, for your mercy and your grace. And we thank you, Lord, that as we go before your throne of grace, by worshiping you, Lord, in spirit and in truth, by your presence, O Lord, and by your anointing, you will break off yokes, remove burdens. O Lord, in the name of Jesus, heal, deliver, and set free in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for all that you're about to do. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We bless your holy name. We bless your holy name. Hallelujah. Father, we give you the praise. We give you the glory for all that you're about to do in the name of Jesus. Somebody say amen. And amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. How many of you ready to worship the Lord? Praise God, praise God. Let us worship God. He is worthy to be praised. How many of you believe that? That He is worthy to be praised. He worthy to receive all the honor and all the praise. Praise God, praise God.
Spirit, you captivated my soul. Spirit and in you. Yeah, and I'm a soul in you. Jesus, we bless your name.
Hallelujah. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we thank you that you blessed us with all heavenly blessings, with having heavenly places. Lord, we thank you in the name of Jesus that by your blessings, O Lord, in the name of Jesus, we, O Lord, in our hearts there is worship that flows out, O Lord, in adoration, O Lord, and devotion to you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you that as we worship you, Lord, in spirit and in truth,
yes,
you are with us, O Lord. Thank you, Holy Spirit, that by your presence, O Lord, you teach us how to worship, to go into the King of Kings,
yes,
and the Lord of Lords.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Lord, we bless you,
yes,
and we glorify you.
Hallelujah.
You are my strength when I am weak. You are the treasure that I see. You are my all.
Oh,
bless your name. Lord, we thank you for your presence in this place. And we thank you for all that you're about to do. In the name of Jesus. Declare your majesty. We proclaim that your name is exalted. For you reign magnificent.
You're my God. Ramashiach, Lamante Ramashiach. You are great. You do miracles so great. There is no one else like you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. 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 Lord, we bless you. Lord, we glorify you. And Lord, we thank you in the name of Jesus. And in your presence, there is fullness of joy. Oh, one more song to the Lord. One more song to King Jesus. Let us all sing.
We thank you, Lord, for what you've already done and what you're going to do. Father, we pray, oh God, that you will touch your people, oh God, through the word that you've prepared, oh God, through your servant, in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray, oh God, that it will minister, oh God, and go and fall on good grounds in the name of Jesus. And Father, we thank you for those, oh God, who have given, oh God, into your storehouse. Lord, we bless your offering today, and we pray for those who have to give, oh God, and those who do not have to give. Father, we bless you today, and we thank you for today's service. In Jesus' name, amen and amen.
Say, Rahul, you are.
Greetings, everyone, in the mighty name of Jesus, our soon coming King, who believe that he's coming soon and he's coming for a church without spot or wrinkle. We praise God for today and for today's service and for what he's already prepared for our pastor. I would like to greet each and every leaders in Christ-centered House of God. I'd extend greetings to Pastor Evan Morgan, Minister Trisha, Minister Norby, Minister Nikki, all God's saints and wonderful people. Greetings, receive greetings in Jesus' mighty name. Praise the Lord. We have an amazing, amazing, powerful service that the Lord is going to do and minister to us through our pastor today. Praise God. Hallelujah. We thank him for what he's going to do and what he's preparing hearts, that what the word will fall on good ground in the mighty name of Jesus. Praise God. Right now, I would like to extend a happy birthday greeting to Sister Paula. Greetings to you. Today is your birthday. God bless you and God keep you and his face continually shine upon you in Jesus' mighty name. Praise God. I'm going to turn over the service to Pastor Stephen, and the Lord has prepared on his heart an amazing word for us. We praise God for that. Bless the Lord in Jesus' name. Thank you, Pastor Stephen.
Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Welcome, welcome to Christ Centered International House of God. We're going to have an awesome night tonight. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. The Lord is good. And his mercy endures forever. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Üdvözlök mindenkit a Jézus nevében. We're going to have translation. We're just going to wait until we're going to be able to connect to Nikki. Give us a minute. In Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So we're going to talk about something very amazing. And we're going to pray in Jesus' name for the Lord to bless us and keep us. Amen. To anoint this word in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. If you have your Bible, it's going to be Ephesians 1 verse 3. Okay. Do you want Biblia?
Hold on.
Yeah. Just put it on there. Yes. Be careful. That's it. And turn it over there. Praise the Lord. So the scripture, and turn it off there. Turn off the your phone.
I did.
You didn't?
I did.
Okay, praise God. Hallelujah. Okay, and just turn on the volume just a little bit. Thank you. Ephesians chapter 1, verse 3, okay? Ephesians 1.
Tehát menjetek bele az Ephesus 1-ben.
Okay, verse 3. Okay, we have an interesting scripture here where the Bible says, blessed be the God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who had blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ.
Tehát Efézus 1. harmadik vers. Áldott legyen az Isten és a mi Urunknak, Jézus Krisztusnak Atya, aki megáldott minket minden lelki áldással a mennyekben Krisztusban.
Praise the name of Jesus. Now, let us pray in Jesus' name for God to reveal to us his word. Amen. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we thank you for your word.
köszönjük, Uram, a Te igéd.
There is a light onto our path.
Világosság az ösvényünknek.
That gives us revelation.
Ami ad nekünk kijelentést.
How to live in this world.
Hogy hogyan éljünk ebben a világban.
How to approach You, Lord.
Hogy hogyan közelítsünk feléd.
Oh, hallelujah. We bless Your holy name.
Áldjuk a Te szent neved.
For Your word.
Mert Te igéd.
That You send from above.
Amit elküldtél felülről.
We bless Your holy name.
Áldjuk a Te szent neved.
And we thank You, Lord.
Köszönjük, Uram.
In the name of Jesus.
Jézus nevében.
For revelation and insight.
Kijelentést és bepillantást.
For all that You have for us tonight.
Mindezt, amit adtok azt ma este számunkra.
Lord, I pray.
Uram, imádkozom.
All those.
Hogy mindazok.
Who are watching.
Akik most néznek minket.
Let their heart be a good ground.
Legyen a szívük egy jó föld.
I want you to put your hands on your heart.
Azt akarom, hogy tedd a kezed a szívedre.
And I want you to say, Heavenly Father.
Mikor mondasz, hogy mennyi atyám.
In the name of Jesus.
Jézus nevében.
I thank You, Lord.
Köszönöm, Uram.
That You gave me a heart.
Adtál nekem egy szívet.
That is a good ground.
Föld.
In the name of Jesus.
Jézus nevében.
That when Your scripture comes.
Amikor a Te igéd jön.
When Your revelation comes.
A kijelentésed jön.
It will fall into a good ground.
Hogy az essen egy jó földre.
In Jesus' name.
Nevében.
Oh Lord, I thank You that You will break yokes tonight. You will remove burdens tonight. And You will bring forth in the name of Jesus.
Jézus nevében.
Hallelujah. Revelations that will change the lives of Your people.
Jelentés, hogy megváltoztatja néped életét.
In Jesus' name.
Jézus nevében.
Amen.
Amen.
And amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So, we read Ephesians 1 verse 2 where the Bible says we are blessed with all spiritual blessings. Amen. By God's grace, I'm going to try to talk to you about how to access the blessings of God. How you can access the favor of God. How you can access the provision of God.
Hogy hogyan élhet hozzá, hogyan juthat hozzá az Isten gondviseléséhez és szívességéhez.
Oh, praise God. But in a simple word, the title is just how to access the blessings of God, okay? But it's more than that, of course. We are blessed when we are in Him.
Áldottak vagyunk, amikor ő benne vagyunk.
But many does not able to access God's blessings and His provisions.
De sokan nem tudják hozzáférni Isten áldásaihoz és gondviseléséhez.
Okay? And even many declare it, many proclaim it, many fight for it, many pray for it.
És sokan ugye kihirdetik, harcolnak érte és imádkoznak érte.
Okay? And we see this over and over in Christianity.
Ezt újra és újra látjuk a kereszténységben.
You know, we read it in the scriptures, I believe, in Hosea 4:6, where the Bible says, or 6:4, that my people perish because of lack of knowledge.
És ugye mondja a Hóseás, azt hiszem a 4:6-ban mondja, hogy az én népem tudás nélkül vész el.
So we need to embrace ourselves and receive revelations today, amen?
Tehát ma vennünk egy kijelentéseket, amen.
So that we are able to find out how God is.
Meg tudjuk tudni, hogy milyen Isten.
We need to learn what He likes and what He hates.
És azt meg kell tanulnunk, hogy ő mit szeret és mit nem szeret.
And we're gonna see also that how in the Bible, in the history, how many people are, praise God, were able to access God's blessings and provisions supernaturally.
És meg fogjuk látni a Bibliában, hogy hogyan az emberek természetes fölöttiához jutottak az Isten áldásaihoz.
Hallelujah. We are living in the age of grace right now.
Most a kegyelem időszakában élünk.
Where we can truly access all that Jesus done for us by His blood. By accepting Jesus as Lord and Savior, you came into the kingdom. And by the Spirit of God, you receive all that you need. Oh, hallelujah. We are in an amazing age. Now, but we are also hoping for a better age to come. And Jesus will bring us a better age where there will be no more cry, no more pain, no more death, no more suffering.
És hiszünk benne, hogy az Úr fog hozni egy olyan korszakot, egy olyan helyet, ahol nem lesz sem gyász, sem kiáltás, sem fájdalom, sem sírás.
The age of the kingdom.
Királyságnak az időszaka.
Hallelujah, praise the Lord. The age of the kingdom. Revelation 21:4 says this. Now, there is a reason I'm going to talk to you about the ages for a short time, okay? I'm going to show you some amazing stuff about the ages, and you're going to know why. Revelation 21:4 says this. And God will wipe away every tear from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, nor sorrow, nor crying. There shall be no more pain, for the former things have passed away.
Jelenések 21:4. És az Isten eltöröl minden könnyet az ő szemeikről, és a halál nem lesz többé, sem gyász, sem kiáltás, sem fájdalom. Nem lesz többé, mert az elsők elmúltak. Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Did you hear what the Bible says?
Az itt mond a Biblia.
There shall be no more pain, for the former things have passed away.
Nem lesz fájdalom, mert az elsők elmúltak.
Hallelujah. Now, Jesus says here,
okay,
this is what the Bible says here.
It's
going to be an age.
There's
no more death, no more cry, no more sorrow, no more pain, no more death. Can you imagine that age? You know, we are longing for that age to come.
Hogy
we are longing to experience it even in our life. But you know, there is something very mind-blowing that I was meditating today upon. You know, when I was began to pray, I began to say it by revelation to the Lord. Lord, I thank you,
Uram, hogy köszönöm,
that you will bring a better age.
Hogy hozom már nekünk egy jobb korszakot.
You're going to bring a better age for us.
Jobb korszakot fogsz nekünk hozni.
And even before you return, there will be some better times.
És mielőtt visszajönnél, akkor is lesznek még jobb idők.
Because you're able.
Mert te képes vagy.
Hallelujah. And when I was began to meditate on this, I began to receive more insight about even certain people in the Bible. That received provisions and blessings that they were not supposed to get in the age they were living in.
Hogy vettek áldást és vettek olyan gondviselést, amiben nem is kellett volna, hogy kapjanak abban a korszakban, amiben voltak.
But somehow,
de valahogyan,
they were able to tap into it.
Képesek voltak azt megérinteni.
I'm going to show you some amazing stuff, but let's first understand the ages for a minute, so that we can able to understand what we're talking about, okay? Hallelujah. The Bible is a book that speaks about ages, and there are seven distinct ages referred to in the Bible.
Tehát a Biblia beszél korszakokról is, pontosan hét korszakról beszél.
All that is written from Genesis to Revelation is related to one or more of these ages.
Tehát egy Mózes a jelenések könyvéig egy vagy többféle korszakra utal.
So everything that God has done,
mindent, amit Isten tett,
everything God is doing,
mindent, amit tett,
and will do,
amit meg fog tenni,
it must be understood in the context of the ages.
Annak a korszaknak a fényében kell megértenünk.
Because God has a specific purpose for each age.
Istennek van egy célja minden egyes korszakra.
Hallelujah. Hebrews 1:1-2 the Bible says, Hebrews 1:1-2 the Bible says, God who at various times and in various ways spoke in time past to the fathers by the prophets, has in these last days spoken to us by his Son, whom he has appointed heir of all things, through whom also he made the worlds.
Zsidó 1:1-2. Minek utána az Isten sok rendben és sokféleképpen szólott hajdan az atyáknak a proféták által, ez utolsó időkben szólott nekünk fia által, akit tett mindeneknek örökösévé, aki által a világot is teremtette.
It is important to understand that God is working out his plan of salvation for all in ages through his Son Jesus Christ.
De meg kell értenünk, hogy a megváltás tervét Isten elkezdte kimunkálni minden egyes korszakban az ő fia által.
Now, so interesting in Hebrews 1, we see that here the Bible says that he made the worlds.
Nagyon érdekes, hogy azt mondja, hogy a világ, az angolban azt, hogy a világokat teremtette.
But in the worlds over here in the Greek is aion, which means actually age or ages.
Tehát itt a világ szó a görögben az aion, ami azt jelenti, hogy korszak.
So the Bible says really here that in the last days spoken to us by his Son, whom he has appointed heir of all things, through whom also he made the ages. Praise the name of Jesus. Now, Ephesians 1:20-21, relating to this so amazingly. Watch this. Which he worked in Christ when he raised him from the dead and seated him at his right hand in heavenly places, far above all principality and power and might and dominion, and every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in that which is to come. Oh, praise God.
Efézus 1:20-21, melyet szeretett Krisztusban, amikor feltámasztott a halálból, és ültetőt a maga jobbjára a mennyekben felül minden fejedelemségen, és hatalmasságon, és erőn, és uraságon, és minden néven, mely nevezhetik nem csak e világon, hanem a következendőkben is.
The scripture, this scripture confirms to us that there are ages in God's plan.
Hát ez megerősíti az az ige, hogy Isten tervében vannak korszakok.
Okay, this present age will end, and it will be followed by another age, which is yet to come.
Tehát ez a korszak majd véget fog érni, és egy új korszak fog következni.
This present age, the age of grace that we are living in, will end at the second coming of Jesus Christ.
És az jelenlegi kegyelem korszak a véget fog érni a Jézus Krisztus második visszajövetelével.
Okay, praise God. So as I said it, there are seven biblical ages clearly stated in the Bible.
Azért mondtam, Bibliában 7 fajta korszak van.
Okay. Now, in order for us to identify these ages, we need to first clearly understand what a biblical age is. It is revealed in the scriptures. Now, watch this. A biblical age is a long period of time which begins and ends with God's supernatural,
tehát ami elkezdődött és véget ér Istennek a természet fölötti,
and dramatic intervention on earth,
és a drámai beavatkozás által a Földön,
impacting the whole world,
és befolyásolhat az egész világra,
in a major and far-reaching way.
Egy fő és
nagy módon.
Nagy módon.
Which completely changes the course of the history of the world.
Ami teljesen megváltoztatja a világnak a történelmét.
Did you hear what I'm saying?
Hallod, amit mondtam.
So we know that from 2020,
tudjuk, hogy a 2020-tól,
when all things going downhill with so many different ways,
ami sokféleképpen egyenesen lefelé ment,
it gave us a sign,
adott egy jelet,
that this age is about to finish.
Ez a korszak hamarosan véget ér.
The Lord's return is closer than you ever thought.
Ez az Úrnak a visszajövetel az közelebb, mint gondolnád.
Because God is about to close this age.
Isten majd le akarja ezt a korszakot zárni.
And before He closed this age,
mielőtt lezárná,
one of the most important thing that you have to do,
legfontosabb dolog, amit tenned kell,
is to be strong in the Lord,
hogy legyél erős az Úrban,
and make sure that all of your family is saved.
És legyél biztos abban is, hogy mindegyik családtagod üdvözülve van.
You can see that one of the scriptures that came to me a while back about Psalm 91, where the Bible says that 1,000 fall at your left, 10,000 on your right.
Nemrégiben eszembe jutott a Zsoltár 91, ahol azt mondja, hogy ez elesnek felőd, ez nem jobb kezed felőd tízözben.
Okay, we hear every day there is something happening.
Mindig valamit hallunk, hogy valami történik.
Somebody dies.
Valaki meghal.
Okay, we have to make sure.
Biztosaknak legyünk benne.
We have to get ready for anything.
Hogy készen legyünk bármire is.
And this teaching will help you also
a tanítás majd segíteni fog,
to see the big picture,
hogy lásd a nagy képet,
and to see what God wants you to do,
és hogy lásd, hogy Isten mit akar, hogy tegyél.
Let's continue. So what is a biblical age again?
Tehát még egyszer, mi a bibliai korszak?
A long period of time,
hogy egy hosszú idő való,
which begins and ends with God's supernatural dramatic intervention on earth.
Ami elkezdődés véget fog érni Isten drámai beavatkozásával.
Oh, praise the Lord. Now there are seven dispensations of all times, okay?
Ez ugye minden időben jövő összesen 7 korszak.
Now, pay attention.
Most figyelj.
We are between two eternities.
Tehát 2 öröki valóság között vagyunk.
Which means we have eternity past.
Úgy azt jelenti, hogy van öröki valóság, tehát a múlt.
And eternity future.
És van a örök valósági jövő.
So, before there was anything created, that there was an eternity.
Mielőtt még bármi is lett volna teremtve, már volt örök valóság.
Praise God. And then when God began to create, He created time.
És akkor Isten elkezdett teremteni, ő teremtett időt is.
Why He created time?
Miért teremtett időt?
To fulfill His purposes through the created man.
Hogy betöltse az ő tervét a teremtett ember által.
He created man for His image and His likeness.
Tehát az ő képére és hasonlatosságára teremtette az ember.
And He created earth,
és megteremtette a földet,
to become heaven's expansion.
Hogy a mennynek a kiterjesztése legyen.
He created earth
a földet megteremtette,
with the people on it,
hogy az emberek benne vannak,
to become worshippers of God.
Hallelujah.
Hogy az Istennek az imádói legyenek.
So the stage of worship is actually earth, the universe.
Az univerzumban az imádatnak a helyszíne az valójában a föld.
Now of course there are perfect worship going 24/7 in heaven.
De persze van tökéletes dicséret és imádat a mennyben 24 órában.
But God loves and cares more about the worship that comes from a heart, a sincere heart that is in this world.
De Isten sokkal jobban érdekli, hogy egy őszinte tiszta szívből jön az imádat innen a földről.
And before God created anything,
mielőtt Isten teremtett volna bármit is,
He knew exactly the history of man, how it's gonna fold out.
És tudta pontosan, hogy lesz majd az emberiség.
Okay, He knew that He's going to fall.
Tudta, hogy majd el fog esni.
Israel as a son fell.
Tehát Izrael, mint az ő fia, elesett.
Angels as sons fell.
Az ő angyalai, mint a fiai, elestek.
But the only begotten son, Jesus Christ,
de az ő egyszülő fia, Jézus Krisztus,
He went through persecution,
szenvedésemen keresztül.
He went through pain and suffering.
Fájdalmon és szenvedésemen keresztül.
But Jesus.
De Jézus.
Stayed faithful.
Hűséges maradt.
An obedient son.
És engedelmes.
So, praise God. God had a redemption plan already planned out before time began. Many times the question would come, what about the people before the cross? Well, there was a provision made for them also. Those who did not know about Jesus Christ as the Messiah.
Akik nem ismerték például Jézus Krisztust, a Messiást.
That he's going to come that he's going to come and pay with his blood for the sins of the world.
Hogy majd egyszer el fog jönni, és az vérével kifizeti a világnak a bűnét.
All those are going to be judged by their actions.
És azok meg lesznek ítélve a cselekedeteik által.
Either they were evil, or they were good.
Vagy gonoszak, vagy jók voltak.
Okay. Now, but there are many people who were waiting for the Messiah, so they were looking at the cross. They were looking forward what Jesus is going to do. So those people who put their faith in Jesus Christ before the cross, they receive salvation by looking forward what Jesus is going to do.
Hát azok, akik hitáltal néztek és bíztak Istenben, ugye várták, hogy Jézus mit fog majd tenni.
I can show you many scriptures about it, but just one thing about it, okay?
De még csak egyet meg lehet erről mutatni.
The Bible says there was a man named Simon.
De a Biblia beszél egy Simon nevű emberről.
And the Bible says that the Holy Spirit promised him before he dies, he will see God's salvation.
Azt mondta, hogy a Szent Szellem megígérte neki, hogy mielőtt még meghalna, Istennek üdvösségét meg fogja látni.
Holy Spirit told Simon.
Szent Szellem mondta Simonnak.
Jesus was still a baby.
Jézus mindig egy baba volt.
Jesus did not even grow up yet.
Még nem nőtt fel.
He did not go up on the cross yet.
Még nem ment fel a keresztre.
Yet Simon knew Holy Spirit.
De akkor is Simon ismerte a Szent Szellemet.
And we can go on and on with this. Praise God. So again, people who are before the cross, they got saved by looking at the cross. What Jesus is going to do? We are after the cross. We are get saved by looking back what Jesus has done on the cross. Now praise God, I don't have time to talk about this in detail, but I'm just going to mention it briefly about the dispensations, okay? We have the age of innocence before Adam's fall. This is including Genesis 2 and 3.
Hát az 1 Mózes 2 és 3.
And after Adam and Eve was cast out from Eden,
és mielőtt kilettek rúgva, ugye Adam és Eve az Eden kertből,
after Adam and Eve was cast out from Eden,
hogy miután kilettek küzdve a kertből,
okay, the second dispensation kicked in, which called the dispensation of conscience.
Tehát utána jött az a korszak, hogy a tudatosságnak a korszaka.
Which is Genesis 4 to 8.
Ami az 1 Mózes 4-8.
No. Genesis chapter 4 to Genesis chapter 8.
Hogy az 1 Mózes 4. fejezetétől a 8. fejezetéig.
Praise God. And then after we had the Noah's flood.
Szóval ugye volt a Noénak az özönvize.
After Noah's flood. We have the dispensation of government.
Jött az államnak a korszaka.
Okay, Genesis 9 to 11.
Az 1 Mózes 9-11. fejezeté.
Praise God. And we know that in Genesis 11, the Tower of Babel, where God dispersed the people.
mondjuk, hogy az Egymózes 11-ben akkor volt a Bábel tornya, amikor Isten megzavatta a nyelvüket.
And then you had the dispensation of promise.
Aztán így bejött az ígéretnek a korszaka.
Which is Genesis 12 to Genesis 50.
Ami Egymózes 12-től a 50. fejezetéig volt.
Okay. I'm just going to go through quickly because we don't have time. And then you had the dispensation of law.
Aztán volt a vérnek a korszaka.
Dispensation of law. Praise God. This is between Exodus 1 to Acts 1.
Abcselegyig.
Igen. Okay, praise God. And then, praise God, then Jesus born.
Amikor Jézus megszületett.
Praise God. And he lived a perfect life.
Tökéletes életet élt.
Okay. After the cross we have the age of grace.
Ugye a kereszt után pedig bejött a kegyelem korszaka.
The church age.
A gyülekezet korszak.
Which also goes from Acts 2 to Revelation 3.
Ami az Apcsel 2-től Jelenések 3-ig megy.
Amen. And what happens at Revelation 4?
Mi történik a Jelenések 4. fejezeténél?
Rapture.
Az elragasztatás.
Oh, hallelujah. And then we're going to have the 7-year great tribulation.
Lesz a 7 éves nagy nyomorúság.
Okay. And we have 2 times 3.5 years, so 7 years.
Tehát 2x3.5 év, az 7 év.
Okay, I don't have time now to get into detail what is about, but and then after that, we have the 1,000-year reign of Christ on earth, kingdom on earth.
Ezután lesz pedig a Krisztusnak az 1000 éves uralma.
Okay, and after this, the new heaven and new earth.
Azután pedig jön az új ég és új föld.
Praise God. And then many more things, okay? Praise God.
Sok más dolog.
Okay, hallelujah. In Mark 10:29-31, the Bible says this. So Jesus answered and said, assuredly I say to you, there is no one who has left house or brothers or sisters or father or mother or wife or children or lands for my sake and the gospel's, who shall not receive 100-fold now in this time, houses and brothers and sisters and mothers and children and lands with persecutions, and in the age to come, eternal life. But when you are first, will be last, and the last first.
Márk 10:29-31. Jézus pedig felelvén mondta, bizony mondom nektek, senki nincs, aki elhagyta házát, vagy fiútestvérét, vagy nőtestvérét, vagy atyát és anyját, vagy feleségét, vagy gyermekeit, vagy szántóföldjeit én éreztem, és az evangéliumért. Aki százannyit ne kapna most ebben az időben házakat, fiútestvéreket, nőtestvéreket, anyákat, gyermekeket és szántóföldeket, üldözésekkel együtt a jövendő világon pedig örök életet, sok első pedig lesznek utolsók, és az utolsók első.
Hallelujah! So Jesus is promising a better age that is going to come.
Hát Jézus egy jobb korszakot ígér.
And what he's saying is no matter what you have lost in this life.
Hát azt mondja, hogy nem számít, hogy mit vesztettél el ebben az életben.
No matter what sacrifice you had to make to be with Jesus and you did not miss anything.
És hogy milyen áldozatot kellett hoznod, hogy Jézussal legyőzted, nem hagytál ki semmit.
Because I have not seen.
Hallelujah.
Nem, ezt nem látták.
Ears have not heard.
És a fül nem hallotta még meg.
What God has prepared for those who love him.
Amit Isten elkészíthet az őt szeretőknek.
Oh, if you would just have a little idea what God has for you in eternity, future.
És ott lenne valamilyen fogalmad, vagy gondolatod a jövőről, amit Isten tartok a számodra.
But first, let's talk about how to access the blessings of God. Amen?
Ezt a beszéljünk, hogyan férjünk hozzá az Isten áldásaihoz.
Now, when God created these ages, there were some amazing people that the Bible mentions.
Amikor Isten megteremtette a korszakokat, voltak csodálatos idők.
God mentions some very interesting people.
Nagyon érdekes embereket említ Isten.
Because in their dispensation,
mert az ő korszakukban,
those things should not happen the way it happened. But it happened. There are people who broke the boundaries God set out. Határvonalat. Okay, there are people who broke the boundaries God set out to access God's provision without covenant. Or even living in the dispensation that will provide the benefit. Or even living in that dispensation that will provide that benefit. Which means that they were not living in that dispensation that would provide the benefits of God. But somehow, they were able to access it. Now watch this, in Psalm 74:17, the Bible says this. It was you who set all the boundaries of the earth. You made both summer and winter.
Zsoltárok könyve 74:17. Te szabtad meg a földnek minden határát, a nyarat és a telet te formáltad.
This is marvelous.
Ez csodálatos.
The Bible says,
Biblia azt mondja,
God set the boundary of everything from the telescope to the microscope.
Isten a Földnek minden határát megszabta a teleszkóptól a mikroszkópig.
Praise God. In the physical world.
Mind a fizikai világban.
And in creation.
A teremtésben.
Oh, praise God. It's marvelous.
Ez csodálatos.
But in also in blessings.
De áldásban is.
Provisions.
Gondviselésben.
And for you to receive anything from God, there are boundaries. There are actually requirements for you to access these benefits and blessings. But there are some people, the Bible says. I'm just gonna mention two for you today, okay? But we can learn from their life. And we can find out some keys. What we can use in our own life. By God's grace. One of them was Enoch. Genesis 5:21 to 23, the Bible says this. When Enoch had lived 65 years, he became the father of Methuselah. After he became the father of Methuselah, Enoch walked faithfully with God 300 years and had other sons and daughters. Altogether, Enoch lived a total of 365 years.
Genesis 5:21.
To
23. Élt pedig Énok 65 esztendőt is nem vette Metusáleket, és járt Énok Istennel, minek utána Metusálek nem vette 300 esztendeig, és nem vette fiakat és leányokat. És lőd Énok egész életének ideje 365 esztendő.
Oh, praise God. Now let me read this for you in the Amplified before I open it up, okay? There was something amazing. Okay? When Enoch was 65 years old,
amikor Enoch 65 éves volt,
he became the father of Methuselah.
Methuselah apja lett.
What is Enoch walked,
és Enoch járt,
in habitual fellowship, in habitual fellowship,
közösségben Istennel,
with God 300 years after the birth of Methuselah. Okay. Praise God. And watch 24. And in reverent fear and obedience.
félelemben és tiszteletben.
Enoch walked with God.
Enoch Istennel járt.
And he was not found among men.
És nem találkozott az emberek között.
Because God took him.
Mert Isten magához vette.
A way to be home with him.
Hogy legyen otthon ő vele.
Now watch this. Enoch was able to access a realm that was beyond his dispensation.
Tehát Enoch bele tudott, hozzá tudott tenni egy olyan, tehát túl azon a korszakon, amin volt.
He was raptured.
El lett tagadtatva.
He lived, remember, he lived in a dispensation of conscience.
Emlékszel, hogy a tudatosságnak a korszakában élt.
And he was able to access a realm where he was actually raptured.
És egy olyan villá, tehát annyira túl tudott jutni a korszakon, amiben van, hogy átrakasztatott.
Okay, I want you to catch this, watch this. He was even able to access a realm prophetically way beyond his time.
És prophetikusan átadott...
He was able to access a realm.
Tehát egy világon úgy át tudott menni.
Okay, prophetically.
Prophetikusan.
So, example, Enoch prophesied about not the first coming of Jesus, the second coming of Jesus. Look at in Jude 14:15. And Enoch also the seventh from Adam prophesied of these sayings. Behold, the Lord come with 10,000 of his saints to execute judgment upon all and to convince all that are ungodly among them of all their ungodly deeds, which they have ungodly committed, and of all their hard speeches, which ungodly sinners have spoken against him.
Ezekről is prófétált pedig Enoch, aki Ádámtól fogva a hetedik volt, mondván, ímé eljött az Úrtól sok ezer szentjével, hogy ítéletet tartson mindenek felett, és felőzzék mindazok ellen, akik közöttük istentelenek, istentelenségükben minden cselekedetéért, melyekkel istentelenkedtek, és minden kemény beszédért, melyet az istentelen bűnösök szóltak ő elleni.
How he was able to access prophetically a realm that was not supposed to be for him?
Olyan tudott Enoch átjutni egy olyan birodalmon, egy olyan kormányon.
Remember, he's prophesying about the second coming of Jesus.
Emlékszem, Jézus második visszajövetelőről beszélt.
And he's raptured.
És aztán el lett tagadtatva.
And he's walking with God.
Istennel jár.
Isn't it sound like how the church supposed to be today?
Nem úgy hangzik, mint hogy a gyülekezetnek kéne lennie ma.
And it happened to be 365 years old when he was raptured.
És ahogy akkor lett elragadott, amikor 365 éves volt.
And the Gregorian calendar is not that old than how long ago was Enoch. Gregorian calendar was way after.
Tehát a Gregorian calendar is ez nem is olyan idős, hogy 365 év, hogy egy évben.
Praise God, because we know that there are 365 days in a year.
365 évben, egy évben.
365 days, Nikki.
365 év.
Nap. 365 nap, Nikki. Come on. Are you okay?
Yeah, I am. It's just sometimes it cuts out.
Oh, cuts out. Okay, no problem.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. English meetings are coming back. I'm telling you, I prophesy now. In Jesus' name. Okay, hallelujah. It's okay. Now watch this. How he was able to do that?
We have to test McTenney.
Now, we know because number one, he's prophetically the shadow of the Gentile church.
Tehát egy prófétikusan a pogány gyülekezetnek az árnyéka.
Right? It represents us.
Tehát minket jelképez.
Not Israel.
Nem Izrael.
Because he was without covenant, right?
You know.
He was not. He was not a Jewish man. He was a Gentile. Right?
Nem egy pogány ember volt, nem zsidó.
Okay? So it represents us.
amiket képvisel.
We who came into the church.
És hogy gyülekezetbe jöttünk.
We who are now the body of Christ.
Amen. Már Krisztus teste vagyunk.
But what was his secret?
De mi volt az ő titka?
What was his secret?
Mi volt az ő titka?
You know, when Enoch was born,
Enoch megszületett.
Adam was still alive.
Adam mindig életben volt.
You know, Adam was still able to impact 8 generations before he died.
Ez 8 generációt tudott befolyásolni Adam mielőtt meghalt volna.
Because Adam still lived about 300 more years.
Tehát még 300 évig élt Adam.
So, his secret was, he knew Adam.
Ismerte Ádámot.
And Adam has spent time with God.
Adam pedig Istennel töltött időt.
Face to face.
Szemtől szembe.
And what he had learned.
És amit tanult.
From the Lord.
Az Úrtól.
Personally.
Személyesen.
He gave it to many people. But according to the scripture here, one of the best disciples was Enoch. Because the Bible says what he learned, he applied.
Because
he walked with God. Okay? And Enoch was raptured before the judgment fell when God flooded the earth, actually.
És Enoch akkor halt, mert mielőtt jött volna az ömvíz, az ítélet a világra.
Enoch didn't die, Nikki. Enoch was raptured before the judgment fell.
El lett ragasztatva Enoch, mielőtt lejött volna az ítélet.
Okay. And so the church will be also raptured before the judgment to fall on this earth.
Hát, hogy az egyház is el lett ragasztatva, mielőtt jön az ítélet a földre.
Praise God. Now look at what the Bible says in Hebrews 11, 5 and 6 about Enoch more. Watch this. By faith, Enoch was taken away so that he did not see death. And was not found because God had taken him. For before he was taken, he had this testimony that he pleased God. Nikki?
Hitáltal vitetett fel Enoch, hogy ne lásson halált, és nem találták meg, mert az Isten felvitte őt. Mert felvitetés előtt bizonyságot nyert a felől, hogy kedves volt Istennek.
And the same way, we must please God.
Ugyanúgy nekünk is...
And walk with God.
Járnunk kell Istennel.
Hallelujah. 365 days in a year.
Hallelujah.
Térnek mind a 365 napján.
Hallelujah. When we please God, when we have this testimony, like Enoch, we're going to be taken up when the time comes. And the Bible says in verses, but without faith it is impossible to please him, for he who comes to God must believe that he is, and he is a rewarder of those who diligently seek him.
Mondja, hogy hit nélkül pedig lehetetlen Istennek tetszeni, mert az Isten elé járó hinnie kell, hogy ő létezik, és megjutalmaz azok, akik őt szeretik.
So watch this. Enoch diligently seek God, because that's what the Bible says about him.
Hát azt mondja, hogy szolgálmaton keresztve Enoch Isten.
I can't hear you, Nikki.
Hello?
Yeah, I can hear you now.
Tehát Enoch szolgálmaton kereste Isten.
Praise God. Hallelujah. Now there was another story.
És volt egy másik történet.
Matthew 15, 21 to 28. Matthew 15, 21 to 28. There's an amazing story about another person, a woman actually. A Gentile woman.
Tehát a Máté 15, 21-től 26-ig van egy történet.
Where now we see something even more amazing.
We látunk egy csodálatos történetet itt.
That how a Gentile woman was able to receive from Jesus.
Hogy egy pogány asszony hogyan tudott venni Jézustól.
Which it would be impossible.
Ami lehetetlen lett volna.
Because
azért
Jesus was sent to his own people.
Jézus a saját népéhez elküldve.
Not to the Gentiles.
Nem a pogányokhoz.
Oh. Watch this. Matthew 15:21. Then Jesus went out from there and departed to the region of Tyre and Sidon. Behold, a woman of Canaan came from that region and cried out to him, saying, Have mercy on me, O Lord, son of David. My daughter is severely demon-possessed. But he answered her not a word. Nikki?
Matthew 15:21. És elmenvén onnét Jézus Tírus és Sidon vidékeire, és íme egy kánai asszony jövén ki abból a tartományból, kiáltva neki, Uram, Dávidnak fia, könyörül rajtam, az én leányom az ördögtől gonoszul gyötörteti. Ő pedig egy szót sem felelt neki.
Praise the name of Jesus. Now watch it, in Mark 7:26,
a Márk 7:26-ban pedig,
the Bible tells us this was a Greek Syrophoenician by birth. She was a Greek, a Syrophoenician by birth.
Tehát egy görög szirofeníciai származású volt ez az asszony.
Okay. And then we continue now with Matthew. And his disciples came and urged him, saying, Send her away, for she cries out after us. Nikki? Remember, we are in Matthew 15, right? Matthew 15 and from 24, right? But he answered and said, I was not except to the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
24. vers. Ő pedig felelvén mondta, nem küldettem csak az Izrael házának elvesztett juhaihoz.
Did you hear what Jesus said?
Tehát az Jézus mit mondott?
Jesus was sent to the lost sheep of Israel.
Izrael elvesztett juhaihoz lett elküldve.
In 25. Then she came and worshipped him, saying, Lord, help me.
Az asszony pedig odaérvén leborult előtte mondván, Uram, légy segítségül nekem.
But he answered and said, It is not good to take the children's bread and throw it to little dogs.
Ő pedig felelvén mondta, nem jó a fiak kenyerét elvenni és az ebeknek fetni.
And she said, Yes, Lord, yet even the little dogs eat the crumbs which fall from their master's table.
Azt pedig mondta, úgy van, Uram, de hiszen az ebek is esznek a mocsalékokból, amik az ő uroknak asztaláról aláhullanak.
Watch this now. Then Jesus answered and said to her, O woman, great is your faith. Let it be to you as you desire. And her daughter was healed from that very hour.
Ekkor felelve Jézus mondta neki, Ó, asszony, nagy a te hited. Legyen neked a te akaratod szerint is. Meggyógyult az ő lányától a pillanattól fogva.
Watch this. The gospel is for the whole world.
Az egész világnak van.
And there was, like Paul the Apostle, that was sent to the Gentiles.
Pál apostol elküldve a pogányok felé.
But not, see, when Jesus was here on earth,
Jézus itt volt a földön,
and he was walking on this world,
a földön járt,
he was only sent to the lost sheep of Israel.
De kis Izrael elveszett juhaihoz lett elküldve.
But there was a Gentile woman.
De aztán itt volt egy pogány asszony.
Somehow.
Valahogyan.
Was able to get access to blessing and provision that she could not able to.
Le tudott férni az ott áldáshoz és gondviseléshez, amivel nem tudott volna.
Without covenant.
Szövetség nélkül.
Without being saved. Without being saved, without, she just knew one thing, that Jesus is Lord.
Hallelujah.
And the Bible says Jesus said to her, great is your faith. Why? She didn't give up.
Hallelujah.
And she worshipped him.
Hallelujah.
And she said, Lord. Jehovah.
Jehovah.
You know, when Jesus was walking with his disciples away from this woman, the moment she went down on her knees and bowed down and began to worship him, and she said, Jehovah, Lord,
Uram,
Jesus stopped.
Jézus megállt.
Oh my.
Hallelujah.
You know, the Lord cannot refuse true sincere worship.
Az Úr nem tudja elutasítani az igaz őszinte imádatot.
By worship.
Imádat által.
And calling Jesus Lord, Jehovah.
Jézus Úrnak hívod Jehovának.
She was able to access the promise.
Hozzátudott az ígérethez.
That was not for her yet.
Ami még nem volt neki ígérve.
This was before the cross.
Kereszt előtt volt.
By faith.
Hit által.
You're able to access the blessings.
Hozzátudunk félni az áldásokhoz.
And the powers of the kingdom age.
És a királysági korszaknak az erőihez.
And we are able to live as a blessings to all.
És áldás lehetünk másoknak.
Did you know that God is more than enough?
Tudod, hogy Isten több, mint elegendő.
I said God is more than enough.
Hallelujah.
Isten több, mint elegendő.
2 Corinthians 9:8 says, God is able to make all grace abound towards you, that you always having all sufficiency in all things may abound to every good work.
2 Korintus 9:8, az Isten pedig hatalmas arra, hogy rátok árasztva minden kegyelmét, hogy mindenben mindenkor teljes elégségetek lévén, minden jó tételmére bőségből legyetek.
God is more than enough.
Isten több, mint elegendő.
You know, He not just heals you.
Nem csak meggyógyít téged.
No. He will make your healing evangelist. He not just delivers you, but gives you a deliverance ministry.
Hallelujah.
He not just able to feed you, but provide you 12 more baskets. He not just bless you, but make your blessings to everyone around you.
Hallelujah.
Hanem mindenkinek áldását tud tenni.
Oh, praise the name of Jesus.
Amen.
But there are things that can hold back God's provisions and blessings in your life.
De vannak dolgok, amik visszatartják Isten áldását és gondolését életedben.
As I said it at the beginning, that we are blessed in all heavenly blessings.
Ja, mondtam a legelején, hogy minden szellemi áldáson meg lehetünk áldva.
But not many people know how to access it.
De nem sok ember tudja, hogy nem férje hozzá.
Because they don't know how to access it.
Nem tudják, hogy nem férjenek hozzá.
And they also prevent themselves to access it.
És saját magukat is megállítják, hogy hozzáférjenek.
Don't see. Godly boundaries are good.
Az isteni határok azok jók.
When you put up godly boundaries in your life,
Isteni határokat szabsz meg az életedben.
When you say, I will not do that.
Azt mondod, hogy én ezt nem fogom megtenni.
I will not go that far.
Nem megyek olyan messzire.
Because I have godly boundaries.
Ez Isteni határaim vannak.
I know who I am.
Én tudom, hogy ki vagyok.
And I know who the Lord is.
Tudom, hogy ki az Úr.
But there are things that can hold back the provisions in your life.
De vannak, amik vissza tudják tartani az Isten gondviselését.
Number one is immaturity.
Az első a Máté.
Immaturity, Nikki.
Az első dolog az életlenség.
Galatians 4:1-2 says, Now I say that the heir, as long as he's a child, differ nothing from the servant, though he be lord of all, but is under tutors and governors until the time appointed of the father.
Galatani 2:3.
1:2.
hogy egy-kettő. Mondom pedig, hogy ameddig az örökös kiskorú semmiben sem különbözik szolgától, jó lehet az Ura mindennek, hanem gyámok és gondviselők alatt van az atyától rendelt ideig.
He says, as long as he's a child.
Addig még ő egy gyermek.
It's nothing different from a servant or a slave.
Ez nem különbözik egy szolgától.
Or a slave. Okay? Though he be lord of all. So it's like this.
Ez az olyan, mint az.
Then in the bank,
vagy a bankban,
you have an X amount of money.
Egy bizonyos mennyiségű pénz.
But you have no access to it.
De nincsen hozzáférésed.
Because you don't know how to put the card into the machine and you don't know the PIN code.
Nem tudod, hogy arra rakd be a kártyát a gépbe, vagy nem tudod a PIN kódot.
Because you're a child.
Hát a gyermek vagy.
The same way how is heaven is.
Ugyanúgy a mennyei dolgok is.
You are inherited everything that God has.
Mindent örököltél, amit Isten odaadott már.
But God held back provisions from you.
De Isten visszatart gondviselést tőled.
Because you don't know how to access it.
Nem tudod, hogy még hogyan férje hozzá.
Because you are immature.
Mert éretlen vagy.
You must grow up on the sincere milk of the Word of God as babes in Christ.
Tehát fel kell növekedned a hamis, Istennek hamisítatlan tején, az igéjén.
And then you have to begin to eat the bread. You have to eat the bread as a young man.
Enned kell azt a kenyeret, mint egy fiatal ember.
The bread represents Jesus Christ.
Ez a kenyér Jézus Krisztust jelképezi.
It represents that you begin to be hungry for His presence, hungry for Him.
Én azt jelenti, hogy éhes leszel az ő jelenlétére.
Hungry for the Word.
És az ígére.
But then you have to become a father in the Spirit.
Azt elvárja, hogy válj.
In the Spirit.
Szellemben.
This is both for men and women, doesn't matter.
Mind a nőknek, mind férfiaknak van, nem számít.
And when you are a father,
atya vagy,
you need meat.
Szükséged van a húsra.
Praise God, because fathers eat meat.
Amen. De atyák húst esznek.
And you must grow up.
Föl kell növekedned.
So that you don't prevent yourself to access the blessings of God for your life.
Hogy ne állíts meg az életedbe az Istennek a jutalmait, áldásait.
I know many people begin to pray when there is trouble hits.
My God. Sok ember imádkozik, amikor jön a baj.
But you have to understand.
De meg kell értened.
When you only pray when trouble comes.
Hogy csak akkor imádkozol, amikor a baj jön.
You just testify that you are still a baby.
Arról tesz egy bizonyságot, hogy te még mindig egy baba vagy.
You have to grow up, make up your mind.
Föl kell növekedned.
Okay? And it has to happen soon if you want the blessing.
Ja, akkor az áldás, akkor hamar kell megtörténjen.
And it's up to you how you grow up.
És ezt attól lettük, hogy hogyan növekedsz fel.
How much you want to be close to God.
Mennyire közel akarsz Istenhez lenni.
And how fast you want to be put yourself into position to receive from God.
És hogy milyen gyorsan teszed magad a pozícióba, hogy legyél Istentől áldás.
Now, there are other things that hinders, like sin.
De más dolgok is vannak, amit megállítanak, például a bűn.
Of course, when you live a sinful life or practice sin, you don't repent from it, you're not going to be able to access God's blessings.
Ha persze, amikor a bűnbe élsz, akkor Isten áldásait nem tudod venni.
If you're complaining,
hogyha panaszkodsz,
you just gonna put yourself again out of the blessings of God.
Megint kiveszed magad is Istennek áldásaiból.
Because complaining takes you out.
Panaszkodás kivesz téged.
But worship brings you in.
Yes. De az imádat, az ügyélet, az bevisz téged.
And thanksgiving.
Amen. De ugye hálaadás.
So when you are thankful.
Hogy hálás vagy.
When you have thanksgiving to the Lord.
Hogy hálada van a szívedben Istennek.
For everything.
Mindenért.
Good or bad.
Jó ér, vagy rossz ér.
That brings you into the presence of God.
Bevisz téged Isten jelenlétébe.
But complaining takes you out.
A panaszkodás kivesz onnan.
Also selfishness.
és az önzőség is.
And pride.
A büszkeség.
Can also hinder you to receive from God.
Az is meg tudja állítani az Isten áldásait életedben.
Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So what can really help you, and what was the secret of these people who were able to access God's blessings and provisions?
Tehát mi volt ennek az embereknek a titka, hogy hozzá tudtak férni Istenek áldásaival vagy gondviseléséhez?
Because the same way they were able to get in,
mert ugyanolyan a módon, ahogyan be tudtak menni,
and able to request their prayer before the Lord, and they get the answer for their prayer.
Ugyan hozták az Úr elé a kérésüket, és megkaptak rá a választ.
There's one answer only.
Erre csak egy válasz van.
Which lines up with the original purpose of God, why He created you.
Ami egyben áll azzal, hogy az Isten eredeti céljával, hogy miért teremtett téged.
Because when you fulfill that,
amikor ezt betöltöd,
the provisions and blessing begin to flow into your life.
Áldások is a gondviselés fognak folyni az életedben.
And all of your need meet with His great supply.
És minden szükséget találkozik azon egy betöltésével.
So what is it?
Tehát mi is az?
Three words.
Három szó.
True, sincere worship.
Igaz, őszinte imádat.
True, sincere worship.
Tehát igaz, őszinte imádat.
Oh, hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. This is the key. This is the way how you can receive and access the blessings of God.
Ez az a kulcs, ez az az út, hogy vedd az Isten áldásait.
Hallelujah. True worship.
Igaz imádat.
True sincere worship.
Igaz őszinte imádat.
Is there is worship in your heart?
Van-e imádat a szívedben?
Is there true thanksgiving in your heart?
Igazi áldás a szívedben?
When you have a need,
akkor van egy szükséged,
and you're able to worship God in the midst of your need.
Hallelujah.
És tudod Isten dicsérni, imádni a nélkülözésedben közepette.
When you're able to worship God in the midst of trouble,
a bajnak közepette tudod őt dicsérni,
God will bless you with provisions and blessings that you cannot even hold.
Hogy Isten megáld téged minden áldással és gondviseléssel olyan, amit nem is gondoltál volna.
Oh, praise the Lord. Let me tell you just two stories.
Csak két történetet elmondok.
Okay, there was a man of God in the past.
Múltban volt egy Isten embere.
In, I'm not too sure if it was 17 or 1800.
1700-1800-as években volt, nem tudom.
And he was an evangelist.
És hogy evangelista volt.
Long time I heard this story actually.
Igen, hallottam ezt a történetet.
The story goes like this. There was a family.
Hát volt egy család.
And this man.
Az ember.
This man was preaching to people.
Emberekre prédikált.
Okay. And there was a couple of days of evangelistic meeting.
Pár napi evangelistai találkozója volt.
And then he sent his family home on a ship to go back home.
És elküldte a családját a hajóra, hogy menjenek vissza haza.
And there was one of the last meeting was coming.
És az utolsó találkozás jött.
No, last one of the last evangelistic meeting was coming.
Oh, az utolsó evangelistai találkozó jött.
Okay, where he had to preach.
Kell prédikálnia.
And he got a telegraph.
Kapott egy telegráfot.
A message.
Egy üzenetet.
And he said, and then he said to the people.
Azt mondta az embereknek.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Hölgyeim és uraim,
my family is at home.
Hogy a családom most már otthon van.
And everybody was cheering and clapping, hallelujah.
Mindenki örvendezett és örültek, hogy otthon vannak.
And he preached a fiery sermon.
És egy tüzes prédikációt prédikált.
Giving God thanks.
Istennek hálát adott.
And after the meeting.
Találkozás után, beszél után.
The people began to learn.
Az emberek megtudták.
That the message what he really got.
Hogy Istentől az üzenet.
No, the message that he got on the telegraph.
Amit az üzenetet kapott a telegráftól.
Is that the ship had sunken and his family died.
Hogy a hajó elsüllyedt és a családja pedig meghalt.
What he meant by they are at home.
Amit értett az alatt, hogy otthon vannak.
Is that they are in heaven now.
De most már a mennyben vannak.
And he had such a faith and such a strength to be able to continue to preach like that.
És olyan ereje volt, olyan képessége, hogy ő tudott még prédikálni azután.
And there are many other stories like this actually.
Sok ilyen történet van.
When trouble hits you.
Amikor jön a baj.
Kneel down.
Térdelj le.
And begin to worship God.
Kezdel Isten dicsérni.
When trouble comes.
Hogy jön a baj.
Learn worshiping God.
Tanuld meg Isten imádni.
And one more thing. Mashul aramandia kaseli manzulakoteo. I cannot finish this teaching. I will finish it another time.
Majd máskor ezt befejezem, az üzenetet.
Hallelujah. But true sincere worship.
Tehát igaz őszinte imádat.
Now let me tell you something very interesting.
Hadd mondjak el valami érdekeset.
If you continue to celebrate the Lord,
hogyha folytatod az Urat ünnepelni,
and you continue to celebrate God for healing,
és ünnepel Istent a gyógyulásért,
and you begin to say, Lord, I thank you that I'm healed.
Uram, köszönöm, hogy meggyógyultam.
Even though you are not healed yet,
akkor is, hogy nem vagy meggyógyulva,
but you are still celebrating,
akkor is ünnepled,
by faith,
hitáltal,
that what you have asked God, you already have it.
De mit kérted Istentől, az már megvan neked.
Your healing will come.
A gyógyulásod fog jönni.
Hallelujah.
Your provision will come.
Provision is at fog jönni.
Your blessing will come.
Áldásod fog jönni.
Look at the people of Israel.
Nézd az Izrael fiait.
When they were sent away, they were scattered by God all over the world.
Isten által mindenhová lettek küldve.
They were still celebrating every year a feast that was non-existent.
Tehát minden évben ünnepeltek egy ünnepet.
A feast that was non-existent.
Ami nem létezett.
Yeah. The feast of barley and the feast of receiving harvest.
Hogy a aratásnak az ünnepét ünnepelték, ami nem létezett.
Because they were not in Israel, they were not sowing seeds, they were not receiving harvest.
Mert ugye nem voltak Izraelben, nem vetettek és nem alattak.
But every year,
minden évben,
for a long time,
hosszú időig már,
they were celebrating it every year.
Minden évben azt ünnepelték.
Are you listening?
Hallod-e?
A non-existent harvest.
A nem létező aratás.
By faith. Until
addig,
when the nation of Israel become a nation again,
akkor Izraelnek nemzete újra egy nemzet lett,
and they began to sow seeds,
elkezdtek magot petni,
and then they began to reap the harvest.
Hallelujah.
Elkezdték aláaratni az aratást.
But watch this. They did not have that for a long time, but they were just celebrating it every year by faith.
Nem sokáig volt, csak hogy ünnepelték minden évben, ugye, hitáltal.
Right? They had no harvest.
Nem volt aratásuk.
But they were still celebrating the harvest.
Akkor is ünnepelték az aratást.
That's faith.
A seed.
Even though you don't have yet what you have asked God.
Akkor is, hogyha még nincs meg neked, amit kértél Istentől.
But you are celebrating.
De ünnepelsz.
And you worship God.
És te
for what he has done. That's faith.
Hallelujah.
And by faith, you will have what you have asked. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. By worship. Can you put on a worship, please?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. The Lord is good.
Amen.
We'll finish this teaching in the name of Jesus one time. Now remember, if you have a need, I told you there are many things that can withhold the blessings of God in your life. But when you worship, sincere, true worship will bring the blessings of God. Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
No matter how you feel, no matter what's happening, no matter what the circumstances are, I want you to begin to worship the Lord in the name of Jesus.
Yes, hallelujah.
Hallelujah. And say, Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, I worship you and I bless your holy name. In Jesus' name, in your home, I want you to begin to bless his name. I want you to begin to worship him in spirit and in truth. And when you touch him by your worship, when you begin to touch him in a place where nobody can, he will touch you in a place where nobody can. And when he comes, he will fulfill all of your needs. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you. Lift up his countenance and be gracious unto you. And give you his perfect peace in the name of Jesus. Yisaronai panaveleka. Vyashem leka shalom. Shalom, shalom. Amen and amen. God bless you in Jesus' name.
God bless you in Jesus' name. Let God keep you and mercify you. Bye.
Master of the universe.